So, you can see this, right? Can you guess the topic? Yeah, is it Pepsi? Can you see it? Actually, can you see it? All right, so here we will give you a fair idea about what exactly our topic is. So, I Parul.
I'm Veda.
We are going to show you a video clip which will give you an idea about what exactly the topic is. Lights, guys, lights.
Tire puncture ho gaya, means 10 minutes lagenge.
Kitni pyaas lag rahi hai.
Haan yaar.
Chal udhar poochte hain. Usse poochte na, cold drink or drink milega kya?
Haan haan, cold drink kyun? Disco bhi poochte na, idiot.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Udhri. Oye, main kya soniyo makhno? Ye ganne de khet vich tamatar kitho?
वो एक्चुअली प्यास लगी थी।
अजी प्यास दी की गल है जदों मोरनी आ गई है खेता विश्ता बिन बादल बरसात करा दे नदिया नहरा सा बैठा ही मंगा दे हुकुम करो जी
नहीं बस ठंडा पानी
की क्या ठंडा तो हेलो ओ ठंडा पीने दे बहाने आई ओ कुड़ी ठंडा पीने दे बहाने आई ते यारा दा टशन देख लो ते यारा दा टशन देख लो हेलो जी अजी यारा दा टशन ठंडा मतलब कोका कोला
ठंडा मतलब
ओके
ग्रेट सो स्टार्टिंग विद गिविंग अ क्लैरिफिकेशन सो द टॉपिक इज कैन यू प्लीज चेंज The topic is actually Coca-Cola in rural market. So here we are going to concentrate on Coca-Cola, but in rural market, okay? Next.
Now we have the introduction of the company. It is the Cola company, the Coca-Cola company. It was founded by Dr. John Pemberton, and it was introduced in the year 1886. Coca-Cola has servings of almost 1.6 billion per day, and it is the world's leading soft drink manufacturer, and it has more than 7 lakh employees with 500 brands. The revenue of Coca-Cola in India this year is 6150 crores, and the tagline for 2002 was "Thanda Matlab Coca-Cola."
So when she said revenue, it is India, it is not rural India first of all. And when we're talking about rural India and their story about rural India, it goes back to 2001 and then 2002 and 3. So that's the time period. Next.
Next we have the products. The products are segmented according to the various factors, depending upon the various factors. The few factors are, the few factors could be the gender, the age group, the geographical conditions, and so on. So we have some sparkling diets which includes Coca-Cola. Then the people who are health conscious, we have the Diet Coke, then Coke Zero, which have less of calories. Then the younger crowd, the children, we have the juices and drinks. So Minute Maid is one of the products of Coca-Cola. For the water, we have Dasani. And next.
So, alright, so first of all, when Coca-Cola came, so it was more like an urban thing, right? So why did they enter the rural market basically? So when you talk about rural market, 75% of, when it comes to India, the population is actually in agriculture sector. More than 450 districts and more than 6,30,000 villages are there. So why not? We got the market, and moreover, think about the time when it was 1990. Monsoon was great. The yield was really high. They had the consumption and they had this purchasing power. So that's also one of the reasons that Coca-Cola thought, let's go there. Second, tax exemption when it comes to agriculture. So when it comes to agriculture, that was another plus point for Coca-Cola to have there. Next. So when I talk about the marketing strategy that they actually go for, so it is about triple A. One is affordability, second is availability, and third is acceptability. Next.
So when we talk about the affordability, definitely it should be affordable to the consumers, to the target market. The major segment that Coca-Cola was targeting was the mass market. So accordingly to the survey they had, the 300 ml bottles were not that popular among the people in the villages, because they cost, first was they were costing rupees 10, and the second thing was they were shared between the two people. So they came with a competitive pricing strategy. They thought of rupees 5 strategy, wherein only a 5 rupee dollar would be spent, not a 10 rupee note. And secondly, they also thought that this would attract a lot of consumers, and hence this was their next one of the strategies. For the availability, one of the targets was it should be available to each and every consumer. They realized that the centralized distribution that was working in the urban areas was not going to work in the villages. So they came up with a different distribution strategy, that was the hub and the spoke strategy. In this distribution strategy, they were actually using the medium commercial vehicles like auto rickshaws and trucks for the transportation of the goods.
Next. So obviously when you talk about rural, you understand the fact that it's not that planned, and they don't have exact retailers. They need, it's all very scattered. They need outlets and everything. So this is what the distribution strategy was about, as you actually spoke about, the hub and spoke. Next. Acceptability. For any brand to get acceptable in that particular sector or particular area, it's very important to convince people. So when we talk about the ruler, so revenue size, they won't get that. So one of the most important thing was advertising that Coca-Cola actually took very strongly. Holdings, paintings on the wall, and then the most important was Doordarshan. That was the only way for them to have advertising. Secondly, very smart move was featuring Amir Khan for the commercial. Why? Any guesses for Amir Khan in 2001, why he was famous? Exactly, on point. Lagan was one of the reasons connecting to Rulo, connecting to Coca-Cola. Third, very important, they took a very generic name, that was Thanda. On point, Thanda was a word for rural areas. Next.
So about the challenges in the rural market, the first challenge was the physical distribution and lack of infrastructure.
Okay, so when you talk about lack of infrastructure, obviously they had to had lot of transport, so they actually got like 5,000 trucks for supply. Secondly, infrastructure, they didn't have refrigerator in rural areas, so they supplied 2 lakh refrigerators for the rural areas. Very important point out here, it's a differentiator for Coca-Cola, that is, when it comes to the refrigerators, only Coca-Cola products can be kept in that refrigerators, no other product can be kept.
The second challenge they faced was the consumption habits and the psychology.
Obviously, they have to match up with the normal lime soda or what tea and all those kind of things when it comes to rural sector.
The next was the promotion and the marketing strategy.
Very well done by Amir Khan, very well done by Holdings, paintings and their strategies of Thanda. Next. So this is the same thing, new initiatives, how they actually worked on it. Doubled the number of outlets, bridging the gap between the price of 5 and 10. Doubled the money spent on Doordarshan, very important. And then targeted local areas, annual hearts, festival melas, next.
So this was the market analysis. The market size was approximately 17,000 crore in the year 2001-2003, approximately. And the Coke and the Pepsi were the main players. They dominated the market. They both had a consolidated market share of 95%. The soft drinks were actually, they were actually first targeting the affluent sector of people. But it was observed after this campaign that 91% of the sales were in the lower classes, middle classes and upper middle classes. Also, the penetration...
Stop, please.
Thank you.